guys, how's everybody doing? It's a beautiful weekend here in the Carolinas. It's gonna just about break 80 degrees, and I thought this is a perfect opportunity, while it's not humid and scorchingly hot out, to go ahead and utilize my new Hobie I-12S inflatable kayak. Now, if you've seen my other videos, you know that I have the Airstream Interstate motorhome. It's a Class B motorhome built on a Sprinter, Mercedes Sprinter chassis. And I have, if you can see through everything that I need to sell at the yard sale, I have two kayaks. These were bought fairly inexpensively for around $250. They're plastic, they're fairly heavy, and they are pretty hard for one person to try and maneuver. And I have the Cadillac CTS Sport Wagon, which I bought the roof rail accessory for, and I actually have the kayak accessory to connect to the roof rails. I personally cannot lift one of the kayaks on my own, and it's just way too cumbersome to try to go ahead and get on top of the roof to take out on my own. So I did a little research, and I had always wanted to try to find a way to motorize my kayak. So I was doing some research and came across the Hobie inflatable. And the reason why I opted for an inflatable really was based on the portability of it. The 10-foot plastic kayaks that I have, if I wasn't putting them on top of the roof rack of the Cadillac CTS Sport Wagon, there's really no place for me to take them or store them in the Airstream Interstate. Now, I probably could put them inside. It would be extremely cumbersome to put them inside of the interstate, and really you can't travel with two 10-foot kayaks in the back of the interstate. They take up all the room you have. You wouldn't be able to walk around. And personally, that's just not what I'm going for when I go camping. So came across the inflatable Hobie and wanted to show you. This is everything that the I-12S inflatable Hobie comes with. So the Hobie's in a duffel bag, and the duffel bag is kind of like a suitcase. It actually has three wheels on the bottom, and this duffel bag measures approximately 2.5 feet. I'm going to call this about 28 inches wide, and the length of it, we're right at about 36 inches. The height of this at the thickest point is about 18 inches. And it's awesome because you can easily tow it around. It does have the pull handle, you've got the wheels, you can wheel it. And ultimately, my thought with having the Hobie inflatable is that you could have two of these, and these will easily store and transport in the back of the Airstream Interstate. Now, the Hobie I-12S inflatable kayak, it is 12 feet long when it's completely inflated, and I'll show you once I get out to the park today how this all goes together. You do have a plastic tube inflator, which is fairly easy to use. You do have to go ahead and lug that around with you. One thing that I like that the Hobie has is this fantastic adjustable chair, whereas my plastic kayaks, kind of hard to see, but all they have is a fabric padded back support to them. More expensive kayaks have more of a hard support, kind of similar to the Hobie chair here. But again, you kind of get what you pay for. Those were $250 or so, and this was around $2,000 from a Hobie dealer. You do have to lug this around with you as well. These legs on the bottom are adjustable. They do come out for easier portability. But what's great with the back of the Hobie chair here is that it is completely adjustable as far as lumbar support and overall tightness of that back. You do have to, of course, take with you your oar and the attachments for the oar. And if you're not familiar with Hobie, Hobie has a very cool paddle mechanism. They call this the Mirage Drive. And the Mirage Drive replacement units of these are around $700 alone. I think this chair replacement is about $400. So again, not inexpensive at all. But if you're like me and you like the whole glamping aspect of getting out and just being able to chill, relax, and have the option and flexibility of either paddling with your or using the pedal Mirage Drive, and I'll show you when I set this up. This Mirage Drive, you actually insert it into the bottom of the Hobie kayak, and you paddle, or pedal, I should say, like a bike. And what happens is that these fins are almost like a fish fin or dolphin fin, and they paddle back and forth, and I'll show you how that looks. And of course, anytime I'm taking a kayak out, I always take my water sandals out. This way I can easily launch the kayak, keep my sandals on, and then go ahead and hop on board. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Forgot about my life jacket. Of course, you don't want to leave without a life jacket. And 7 items. So there are quite a few pieces here that I'm going to go ahead put in the back of the Cadillac CTS Sport Wagon. I'm not taking the RV to go to the lake today. I'm just going to haul everything in the back of the wagon, and we'll go ahead and get on our way. I-12S inflatable kayak a few months ago. It's a 2017 model, and I had never known of any Hobie inflatables. I had known of the Hobie brand since I had seen some of their hard shell kayaks with the Mirage Drive in some outdoor stores, and was always intrigued by how you could essentially self-propel the kayak by pedaling. I didn't realize that there were any manufacturers that actually made that, and started digging around a little bit and saw a good number of options for hard shell kayaks. And again, this was during my research for trying to find a way to propel the hard shell kayaks that I currently have with some sort of battery-powered motor, thinking it would be cool to be out on the water and just kind of scoot along and enjoy a beautiful day when I'm out camping. Then that research led into the inflatables, because again, I can't really transport easily a hard shell kayak with both the Cadillac CTS Sport Wagon by myself or in the Airstream Interstate RV. So the inflatables wound up being the perfect option. Now there are some far less expensive inflatable kayaks that you can easily find online on Amazon. They don't include any type of self-propelling mechanism. Now there are some battery-powered motor options out there, but they're going to cost nearly as much as buying a Hobie kayak with the Mirage Drive as a kit together. And so I opted to go ahead, and I tend to like manufacturers or stock kits that are already put together. I can go to one source for a warranty or repair needs and not have to worry about multiple manufacturers. And so Hobie just wound up being the best option out there that I could find. Now the Hobie inflatable I-12S kayak is under 100 pounds altogether, and that's referring to the kayak itself in the duffel bag carrying case that it comes in with wheels. It's probably closer to around 80 or so pounds. It's still not light. And I think when it arrived and I took it out of the box, it definitely wound up being larger than I originally anticipated. What really caught me off guard, or that I guess I really wasn't thinking of necessarily as far as transport in the back of the Airstream Interstate, is that you do have the large cylinder plastic inflator, you've got the oars, you've got the separate seat, you've got the Mirage Drive, and then, of course, on top of that, you've got the kayak itself in the duffel bag. And not everything fits in the duffel bag, so it's not a neat all-in-one kit that you can shove in the duffel bag very easily and then put in the back of the interstate. It's definitely manageable, but that's one thing to keep in mind if you're looking for something very easy that you can kind of stow and go. I would probably look into a smaller inflatable kayak or a different inflatable kayak and forget the Mirage Drive propelling unit. If that's not something that's very important to you, you can absolutely find a kayak that you could more easily transport all in one kind of duffel bag. Now, I did experience right out the gate an issue with the rudder. The Mirage I-12S inflatable kayak, as do all Hobies, it has a rudder, which is really just an added bonus, on the back of the kayak. And with that rudder, there are two levers that are attached to, or actually there's one controlling mechanism that attaches to your chair, and it's on a rotating dial, and you can turn it to the left or to the right. And what that does, there's essentially a pulley system of cords that attaches to the rudder on the back of the kayak, and those cords turn the rudder to the left and to the right, which allows you to control the direction that you're paddling essentially in your kayak with the simple use of the control knob. Totally awesome feature. And unfortunately, right out the gate, what had happened was that inside of that control knob, the cords were not tight enough. There was not enough tension, and they are adjustable. They're intended to be adjustable back at the rudder. And what was happening was that as I was turning that knob control to the left and to the right, the cord inside of that control, inside of the little pulley mechanism, was getting stuck. And not knowing that, I was adding a little more force to turn that knob to turn the rudder. And at this point, I was out on the water. This is the first time that I took the Hobie out on the water, which this is exactly why you want to have your oar with you your paddles, because in case of an emergency, a cord were to break or become jammed, that oar is your backup. And so what had happened was that the cord essentially got jammed inside of the control, and I could not use the rudder to steer anymore. I could still propel myself, but I could not steer. So I had to raise the rudder out of the water and was able to propel myself with the Mirage Drive, but then had to use the oars to steer. So fortunately that worked out. I was able to get back to shore right before a storm was coming, and everything turned out fine. I was able to contact the Hobie dealer, and the Hobie dealer was extremely helpful in me forcing that rudder control knob. It actually broke some of the plastic and where that control mounts to the seat. The plastic broke under the force, and so there was no way now for me to remount that control back to the seat, which then makes it fairly hard to use the control if it's not mounted directly to the seat. So the dealer was able, I had to send a few pictures, the dealer was able to contact Hobie, get a replacement kit sent, and since the Hobie dealer for me was out of state, I do have a Hobie dealer locally, but the dealer that I purchased it from out of state was actually able to send me that rudder control directly, and it probably took me 15 minutes to go ahead and replace the rudder control and restring it. Very straightforward, very simple, and needless to say, I'm very impressed by the Hobie dealer's response time, helpfulness, as well as Hobie's warranty. The craft is extremely well made, very rugged, except for the fact that I did not realize to check the tension of the rudder control. If I would have checked the tension of those strings inside of the rudder control, I would have been able to have prevented the damage to the actual rudder control knob. So now that's something that I always pay attention to and make sure that that control is very tight. And that way as well, you'll find that when the cord is tight, you have a much quicker response time. When I turn that rudder control to the left, the craft turns to the left without any lag, and likewise turn it to the right and the craft turns to the right. So ever since it's been replaced, we've been up and running and it's worked great. Day out. So this park is in my county where I live, and there's the boat in front of me. They have two boat slips,
And I'm going to go ahead and get around as soon as this horse trailer goes. So they do have two boat slips. Usually what I do is back the CTS wagon down to the water and unload. It's pretty busy out here. They do have a beachfront park. And then camping is on the other side of the lake with a separate entrance. Speed limit's pretty slow, so I want to make sure I'm abiding by that. They do have horses sometimes that will walk along the road, so I don't want to spook them. And it looks like it's 'a busy day. Some kayaks. Actually, I see a lot of folks with kayak racks. So let's see how it looks down here. Yep, more kayaks. A boat. Not going to get in the way of the boat that's down there. I'm going to let those people go ahead and launch. So I'm just waiting for the two current boats that are launching to go ahead and wrap up. It looks like there's another boat coming in, and I've got a gentleman with a larger canoe waiting to go in, so we're going to have to finagle this. And there's another boat that just arrived. Alright, so this is when I need to go ahead and invest in the wheels for the Hobie so I could go ahead and have it set up where I'm parked, and those wheel simply insert on the bottom side of the kayak. And in doing so, you can inflate the kayak, put your two wheels in, and then one person can easily go and walk the kayak down to the water, and the wheels assist you with doing that as one person, because it's 12 feet long and there's no way that I can walk or lift the kayak to the water by myself. So I'll probably wait for everyone to get done and hope that nobody else comes in the meantime. And people aren't taking too long down there, which is good. So we'll see. It's a beautiful 81 degrees out. The water looks absolutely gorgeous, so I'm anxious to go get out there once the chaos of everybody launching and picking up their boats ends. So we'll see. Hey, so I finally made it out on the water. Unfortunately, there was so much traffic going on at the boat ramp that I really didn't have the opportunity to show you how the Hobie I-12S inflatable kayak is put together. It probably took me all of 10 minutes. Nah, 5 minutes. I mean, it's a pretty quick assembly. And on top of that, one of my camera batteries died, so I was hoping to have two cameras rolling, and I wanted to conserve some of the battery for when I'm actually out on the water. But it's absolutely gorgeous out. I'm surprised how many kayakers are actually out today. I think there's probably more kayakers than boats. And again, it's just an absolutely perfect day. So I'm going to spend probably a couple of hours and just fiddle fart around the lake. I usually like to go around the perimeter and just look and see what kind of birds and nature I can find, and just soak up some sun. So we'll see how it goes.
So this is the rudder control that I was talking about that had to be replaced inside of here. The cords for the rudder were completely tangled. So Hobie was able to send me, under warranty, a brand new rudder control. And this rudder control controls in the back, if you can see the rudder. And then there is another cord here that if you were in shallow water or when you're getting out of the water, you pull this and that will lift the rudder back up. So I'll show you what that does. So here's pulling it up and then putting it back in. So one thing, like I mentioned earlier, whenever you're in shallow water, you want to make sure that the Hobie Mirage Drive fins underneath are completely against the bottom of the kayak, and you do that by pressing the pedals to the furthest extreme in either direction. So currently like this, both of the fins would be lifted up against the bottom of the kayak. And then if you were in shallow water again, you would really just want to make quick pedal movements like this to propel you along in very shallow water, and that way your fins are not fully extended. And I'll show you what it looks like when you take these fins out. So there are two locks that you want to unlock, and you don't want the fins like this because they're currently at the bottom against the kayak, so you won't be able to pull the Mirage Drive completely out. So you want to have them completely vertical, and then you can simply lift the fins out just like that and reinstall them. They'll automatically lock with the locks, and away you go. So one thing on the Hobie Mirage Drive you have to be on the lookout for whenever you're pedaling is that bolt. If you can see, it will hit right up against the screw on the left, and you'll start to get a little friction of metal on metal. So when I get it out of the water, I'll have to tighten that bolt so that they're not touching again. And that's one of the only real things that you have to keep an eye on during every trip, is tightening those bolts so that you don't have the metal rubbing against the metal, wearing those parts down. It's just an absolutely peaceful cove back here. There's a few birds, some fish are jumping. So quiet. There's some turtles. What's great with the Hobie is that it's got a fantastic turning radius, so I can really get down in some of these coves. You can see some of the, probably just missed it, or a couple of fish jumping. But I can get the Hobie down in a cove and do a really quick turn. So this is probably a good spot. So I'm gonna crank it to the left, so the rudder is turned to the left all the way. And do a really nice circle. Now this is a 12-foot kayak, and without looking to see what the turning radius is, I'd say it's probably twice its length. So we're probably sitting at about a 24 foot total circle that it makes from side to side, which I don't think is bad. I don't have a lot to compare it to, but it's got a really good maneuverability on the water. No snakes today, so far. Nothing says relaxation like power poles in the middle of the lake. I don't think he was very happy that I stalked him. But it was beautiful, nonetheless. It's a beautiful, quiet cove. Got a great breeze. Of course, I forgot to put sunscreen on my knees the last time. I didn't put sunscreen on my knees. I got a little red. But I think I'll be okay. I'm not going to be out here a super long time. We'll see. Now, one thing that's great about this park is that usually back here there are a couple of gorgeous bald eagles that you'll usually find flying around. I haven't seen them out today. I've seen a couple of hawks. I don't know what that was. A couple of things just skipped across the water in front of me. There's another fish jumping. What the heck? I have no idea what those are. They must be hungry. Yep, do you see it? Jumping fish. Oh my gosh, it feels so good in the shade. I had to take a second to chill out for a second. I'm like, it's pretty bad when your arm crease right here starts to sweat. Don't tell anybody. This fatty's got to lose some weight. 15 pounds. All right, 15 pounds. So I started a week ago, and I've been eating some healthy, low-cal meals. I've been using the Green Chef meals that I ordered. And I actually need to make one this evening to help kickstart my week. I've got to get myself in gear. I need to start moving a little bit more. I've got an elliptical I've got to start using, because I'm finding the older I get, the calories, sadly, or the weight, sadly, is just not falling off as easily as it used to. So between a healthy diet and a little extra activity, I'm hoping I can go ahead and shed about 15 pounds. In the meantime, I'm growing my beard out, and I wanted to go ahead and let that get filled in for a change. So we'll see how that does and how long I decide to keep that. But in the meantime, I'm trying to get some exercise out here, get a little sun, and then I'll head back in and call it a day. Today. So I was out on the water a couple hours, which was a good time. Started to get a little hangry, and thought this was a good time to head on out. I've got a couple of lottery scratch-off tickets that I'm going to go cash in that I one a few bucks on, and then I'm gonna head home and find something to prep for dinner. So I'm almost home, and I'm gonna go ahead and unload the Hobie and let it dry out instead of packing it back. Usually the best thing to do is to unfold it. Once I get it back home, I'll lay it out in the garage, let it air dry, and then that way I can clean it before putting it back in its duffel bag. As always, like, thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you like my content. Please leave any comments or questions below. Again, I know I really didn't get to show a whole lot of the inflating and assembly of the Hobie based on just all the activity going on at the boat ramp today and one of my camera batteries dying, but I'm happy to answer any questions you have. Until next time, take care. We'll see ya. Thank you.